Today we're going to learn how to install a switch end stop on the ramps version 1.6. Now I need to point out a couple of things on the ramps to make this clear. First of all, we have our X minimum, our X maximum set of pins, our Y minimum set of pins, our Y maximum set of pins, our Z minimum set of pins, and our Z maximum set of pins. These are our I2C pins that don't have anything to do with the end stops. Here's a close-up of the switch end stop, and I need to point out some things on here. First of all, we have the switch, which is almost in the center of the screen. When this is depressed and creates a circuit, it will cause voltage to go out through the signal pin over here. Now keep in mind, we also have our ground pin underneath here and our voltage pin. They also have surface mount resistors and capacitors on the board that you can see where it says C1 and R1. And over on the far side over here, we have a little diode that will light up when a circuit is created. So here is the connector for the end stop. As you can see, it's a notched connector, and at the very top of it, it has a green wire. That's our signal wire. And then the wire in the middle, the black one, is our ground, and the bottom is our voltage. So to connect this, all we need to do is slide it right into the connector right here. And that's all we have to do for this side of the end stop. So in order to show you where we need to connect things, it shows right here on our RepRap.org wiki for the 1.6 connectors for our pinout diagram. So what I want to show you is that here's the X minimum, the X max, the Y minimum, the Y max, Z minimum, and the Z max. But over here they have S, negative, and positive. The S is signal for all these pins. Then over here, the negative for all these pins is ground. And then the positive is voltage. So keep that in mind. Now for the I2C, which is not related, it obviously writes really small positive, negative, and then the pin numbers or names of them. In this case, they're for communications with I2C, which we'll go into some other time. So now that we want to connect it to our board, we need to know, where our actual pins are. And as you can see, signal is on top for a pin, and then it says negative just below it. That is actually ground. So I'm going to slide it in like so. And that's all you need to do to set up the end stop for your X minimum. Okay, to program the board, what we need to do now is we need to connect the big side of the USB to the Mega 2560 board below for the Arduino. And we need to connect the small side to the computer. And you may hear a beep. Okay, to program, I have the Mega 2560 file open for the Marlin firmware, which is 2.0.x. This is a recent download. So in previous videos, I've already showed you how to adjust the motherboard. So I'm going to show you that real quick. So motherboard in this case is actually the default for our board, which is the board underscore ramps underscore 14 underscore EFB. So I'm going to do a search now with Control F on end stop. And what it shows us is the actual category for end stops. These are our settings that we can set. So as you can see over here, it's got the use X minimum, use X maximum, or excuse me, it says use X minimum, use Y minimum, use Z minimum. These are the enabled pins. If you wanted to enable other pins, you would have to remove the comments, but I don't recommend that because you only need one direction for your end stops. And then down here, they have a couple of interesting things. This is for float states. So they have an end stop pull up for the upward state, and then they have one for the downward state. These I normally don't use. If you want to play with them on your own, you're welcome to do that, but we're going to leave them alone for the moment. But what we're interested in is down here. What's going on is when we're using the end stop, the logic might be backwards from what we're expecting. So in the case of where it says open, it may say closed or triggered. So to reverse that state so it says open instead of triggered, we need to change this to true. And in this case, on this particular end stop, that may happen. So now that we've changed that, what I'm going to do is I'm going to actually upload our build after we built it. But we need to check under tools and make sure that we have the Mega 2560 selected, which we do. And we have to make sure that we have a COM port selected, which is COM 13 in this case. So we're good there as well. So in order to build this or compile it, we could either use the checkbox, which will actually just build. But in this case, we want to build and then upload. So we're going to use the arrow right here. So I'm going to click on that. And this may take a few minutes to actually build and then upload to our board. So now that the build has completed, we can see that it says done uploading. So we should assume that it's correct. Now there's one thing I need to tell you about this tutorial. No one is paying me or sponsoring me to do a tutorial on this subject. And I did purchase all the equipment with my own money, but I will be placing Amazon affiliate links in the description to help you find this better and offset my costs. Okay, in order to test this, what we need to do now is we need to open up Pronerface, which I have in my print run directory. And I'm going to click on Pronerface. And I'm going to connect to the device. And as you can see, the current version is Marlin 2.0.1. So to check the end stop status before we trigger it, we're going to type M119, press enter. Right now you can see that the X minimum is open, but the Y minimum and Z minimum are triggered. That's because there's nothing connected to them. So what I'm going to do next is I'm going to trigger with my finger the end stop, and I'm going to press send again for the M119 and see what happens. And as you can see, it says triggered. So now if I remove my finger from the end stop and I press send again for M119, it says open. So if you like my tutorial, please press the like button and subscribe. And thank you for your time.